How to random fill a document in Photoshop using a custom shape. Now, custom shapes can be great sources for pattern designs. First thing to do, create something like this. Very quick and easy. Simply go to, complete fresh document. And I'm going to go over to the custom shape tool. And your custom shape tool may be in a completely different position, because of course you can customize Photoshop's toolbar. So select custom shape tool, and then go and select a shape. Now, shapes here, probably completely different from ones you've got. So you might have just the standard leaf trees, wild animal, etc. We'll select one of those shapes. I'm going to select one of my ones, which is a diamond design, but again, select any of the other shapes as well. And then use the shape option. You've got a number of options here, shape, path, or pixels. You could use pixels as well, perfectly reasonable, but I'm going to use shape. Use the pixel option. Best thing to do is create a new layer and then add the pixel design to that. So with that selected, now you can change your color. So I'm just going to go for a start point color. And I'm going to go with a gray. The reason I'm going to go for gray is quite good for just being able to vary the color. So you can set the brightness and change the color, randomize that in the fill command. So I'm just going to go to click OK there. And I'm going to create my design. Now you can make it any size, doesn't particularly matter. I'm going to go with about like that size, but you can vary it. Now the design, unfortunately, when you do a random fill in the edit and fill command, doesn't always match the size of where you think it's going to be. You've got a preview, just doesn't always match it. So that's an issue to bear in mind. So I've just got this design here. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove the background. So I'm just going to go for layers. So layers. So window and layers. Now just go over here, background layer. Make certain that's selected and then remove it. Yes, I want to delete the background layer. So it's gone. Now you can of course create something much more complex than this. You could create a whole variety of different designs, but I'm just showing very basic design here. Now you've got transparencies background. The reason that's why I got rid of the background, because I want the transparency. The fill command, I mean, if you use the random fill without doing this, you'll end up with squares with design in it, but still it will just look a bit odd. So it's nice if you can get rid of the background. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to use the, go over here to the rectangular marquee tool, and I'm just going to select that area. And I'm just going to go for, so I could have gone for the entire document, but I just want that, just that little bit there with a bit of gap around it. You can change that up to you. Once you've done that, edit and define pattern. Click OK. Now I'm just going to go back to a fresh document again. So I've got completely white document again there. And then I can go to edit and fill. And then go to pattern. And that's for the contents. There's obviously another options. You've got foreground, etc. But the one I want is pattern, because that's where the random fill is. And this is in 221, but it's 219, 218, etc. should have this feature. So make certain script is on, random fill, and I'm using normal and 100%. And go and select the one you just created, and there's design there. Then click OK. And you can see the design there. That's a random fill, so it's just lots and lots of those diamond designs all added all over the place in different colors, because I've got color randomness set to fairly high and brightness randomness. If I put that down, see, it just goes to a grayscale, which is fine, of course, if that's what you want. But I'm going, I want full on color, and I've set the color scale. Don't make it too much larger than what you created the design at. But like I say, the preview doesn't always match the end results. You might have to apply it a couple of times. You can set the density, say like 9 or 10, and then I've set a low value. So you've got a mix, very small, so lots of very small of these patterns, as well as some slightly larger as well. And I could add rotation as well, so I could go rotate pattern. You can see then just rotates it at different angles. Then click OK, and you can see what happens. You've got this design created here, and that's using that design, that pattern you'd created earlier, the one with the transparent background. But of course, what you can do, you can always go to edit and fill, click OK. And of course, you could select a different pattern here. You don't have to use the same one, but I'm just going to apply again. Now, sadly, there's no repeat fill command other than just simply going to edit and fill. Never understood why they've never added a feature like that. Would make it so much easier. But then again, of course, what would be even nicer would be repeat fill 50 times feature. And it could just, but of course, you can always maybe create an action or something like that. But it would be nice if you could have a sort of more automated feature for it. Click OK. And you can see design there, and it's building up. Now, I could have created this on a layer, and I could have then had the transparency of design there and added additional effects. So that's quick random fill. Now, just quickly show you can do other ones. So I've got, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you that you can create one using pixels. So it's not just using the shape layer. But I think the shape layer is always the best because you can always add effects to it. Because you can, it's basically a smart object. You can make it a smart object, then add some smart filters. So like blurs and maybe a shadow or something, or maybe bevel, and then define that as a pattern. But this one, I'm just going to quickly go again to the custom shape tool. And this time, I'm going to use pixels. And I'm just going to select a different diamond design there. I'm just going to go quickly down. Oh, one there. So I've got a design there. And now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a layer. So new layer. So again, I can add the transparency. Don't have to do that. If you want the, but you'll end up always with that square design, which doesn't look brilliant as a pattern. So new layer. You can see the new layer there. And then what you can do, you can add your design. I'm going to go with grey there. Again, you could just use as a colour here. And this time maybe add some green. And you can, of course, add different shapes. You don't have to add the same design. Add some there. And then maybe, let's go for a different design as well. Another design. And maybe, so you can see a variety of different designs can be created, not just a very simple, but a more complex design that can be used in this random fill. So you've got this design now, and what you can then do, of course, is you can always, because it's a layer, you can go to layer style, maybe bevel and emboss. And you can see you can bevel and emboss it, and maybe drop shadow. I don't want it to go off the edge because you're going to get it just cutting off. So that's not so great. So just move that up a bit. And maybe spread a bit, size, and you can just vary it. So you've got this design now. It's got a shadow, it's got a bit of bevel, and then you can again go to the background, remove, yes. And then once you've done that, again, do exactly as before. Now make sure you avoid just cutting off the shadow. Just go select all the way around using the rectangular marquee tool. Once you've done that, then go to define pattern. And you can see you've got another pattern there. Now I'm going to go back. So back to a complete fresh document. Don't have to do that, of course, but that's what I'm just going to show you applying this fill. And again, what I said you could do, you could apply it on a layer. So layer and new layer. Click OK. So now you've got a layer to add your fill to. So edit and fill. And again, pattern again, make certain the contents is pattern. Set the script on, make certain that is definitely on. Sometimes it seems to set it back to where it's not on, and it just doesn't do it right. And then go for, right, there's obviously a number of options there. Brick fill, they're all pretty good. Symmetry fill is excellent. Random fill, but in this tutorial, showing random fill. So click OK. And you see, in this case, I've got that original diamond. Quite easy mistake, because you can't change it in the other one. And I do that quite often. I run it and I think, oh, talking away, what I need to do is go down and remember to change it to the one that we just created. It does help. So it's one of those things. And of course, you could change blending modes if you want to do that as well. Perfectly reasonable. I'm just going to run that script with that. And you can see then you've got your design there. And again, you could change these other settings. Perfectly reasonable. Change density and color randomization. If you didn't want that, you could go for, say, obviously, because they're not gray, there's no color. And obviously, you can see the greens and the pinks that were in the original design. That's what you're getting. If you go back there and you set it exactly without any randoms, you just get what you created in the initial design. So I like some variation there. So push that up again. You notice when you do it, it does a bit of processing as it runs through it. And as I said, the preview here does not match. Now it does match it. I think if you actually looked at it, if you examined the thing, but it just doesn't look like it when you see the end result. That makes sense. But I think it does generally generate something like this. You can see that the basically does fill it fairly nicely. But if you look at it, obviously the rest, if you looked at further out, you would actually create this design that you had there. I think that's my understanding of it. Unless it just doesn't produce, the preview just doesn't match at all. That would make no sense. But anyway, that's edit and fill. That's again, unfortunately, means you have to run it again. So you can run it again and you can see, but you've got gaps in there. So it's possible. And again, so now you can see the jumble of designs that have been, and they're all created as, they haven't spread them out in any way. It's what you created, just random colours. And again, you could do another edit and fill. But you can also, of course, you've got this design, it's on a layer. What you can do, you can go to layer, layer style, bevel emboss, and you could add bevel emboss to that. Or maybe, obviously it's not going to be much good because it's virtually filled now, but drop shadow, you can see a little bit of shadow there. Or maybe gradient overlay, and you can see create a different variety of different effects there. And again, because it's on the layer, what you can do, you can quickly go to maybe filter and liquify and just modify your design. So you can just tweak it. So you don't have to keep it exactly as you created it. You can modify those designs. And of course, what you can do then, you can always run it again. Add that on top. So you can always go edit and fill. And again, use that pattern or use a variety. You could have saved a variety of patterns, similar sort of designs. You have like 50 of them all the way there. Right, run it, random fill, click OK. And of course you can say, oh, I don't want the density so high, so just reduce the density down and click OK. And you've got that applied on top of all those liquefied designs. So you can create all kinds of really quite random, unusual backgrounds, overlays. You can use these overlays, maybe use a backdrop for type, maybe use it as a frame design so you can make it an edge around something, and maybe use it as a texture, because you can always, of course, turn around and say, well, image adjustments, and maybe black and white. You can turn it into a black and white, into a texture, and so on and so on. So there's a variety of different designs. You can create this, and then maybe use it in the 3D commands. Create some nice 3D effects. There's thousands of possible things you can do with it. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Please subscribe to Graphic Extras. Always add new tutorials about Photoshop, Affinity Photo, Affinity Designer, Painter, Illustrator, and many, many others. Also, please add some questions, some comments. What have I done right? What have I done wrong? What sort of things would you like to find out more about? It's always great to know. Also, a dislike or like. Thank you much.